Jimmy, would you ask the blessing?
Most kind and loving Heavenly Father, we come to you again tonight, Lord. Thank you for this another opportunity to come out and worship in your house.
Yes, Lord.
I ask that you would be with the remainder of the service, be with Pastor Hurley as he brings us.
Yes, Lord.
Now, Lord, we just ask that you bless us all, bring bless us and give and those who can. These things we ask in Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Tangled in a cord, just throw it away.
Hey.
Is that all? Can we hear it? Can you hear Brother Hurley?
Say something, Hurley.
Good evening.
Okay, we got it. All right, just a minute. Just a minute. We're going to turn this over to Brother Hurley, and whatever God's got laid up on his heart tonight, he usually sings a song or two. We hope we can encourage him to sing one tonight. Amen. I know he loves doing that, and he loves serving the Lord, and we love him. Again, he's an inspiration in my life. We've had a lot of talks over the years, and we still love one another. Amen.
Amen.
Brother, you want Mondays? Let's give Brother Hurley a hand there.
Well, I had a couple of songs picked out when I left home. I was going to bring my big song book, and I ran off and left it.
What about the one I didn't make the paper?
You know what? You just read my mind, because that's trying to find it. The song is, It Made News in Heaven, when I got saved.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
dude. Wasn't too many people rejoiced here.
Yeah. Right.
But the Bible says that in heaven they rejoice over one sinner that repented more than over the 99. So I'd like to see a lot of rejoicing take place.
Amen. Amen.
We're having a revival, you know, and we like to get revived. But I'd like to see some people saved. I'd like to see some of the young people come in.
Yes.
Before it's too late.
Amen.
I didn't make the paper in this world when I prayed through. It didn't seem to matter to all but just a few. But in the golden streets of glory, celebration banners wave.
Yeah.
It made news in heaven when I got saved.
Amen.
All the angels were rejoicing. The hallelujah rang when Jesus touched my life and I was changed. Everyone in glory's realm, they all knew me by name. It made news in heaven when I got saved. Not long ago, a beggar, now a child of the King.
Amen.
This old world just shrugged its shoulders. It didn't mean a thing, but it was God's approval. My spirit really craved. It made news in heaven when I got saved. All the angels were rejoicing. The hallelujah rang They all knew me by name.
Yeah, buddy.
It made news in heaven when I got saved.
Amen. Yes, it did.
And we all feel good when we see someone saved. You know, we
Amen.
Rejoice.
It
pleases God to see His children come back.
Yes, that's right.
We left Him. You know, we left Him and we were lost. And it pleases God to see His children, you know,
Amen.
Come back and repent of their sins and live for the Lord.
Right.
Got one of them here I'm going to sing. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. Saints all over with Him there. You could hear praying everywhere. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. The graves burst open everywhere.
Yeah, buddy.
The graves burst open everywhere. Saints went flying through the air. You could hear shouting everywhere. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. I felt myself begin to change. I felt myself begin to change. I had a robe as white as snow. I didn't have a spot. I was ready to go. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. The gates of pearl swung open wide.
Yes,
the gates of pearl swung open wide. No more heartaches, no more tears. You could hear praying anywhere. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. I saw the river of life run cool and clear. I saw the river of life run cool and clear. There sat God upon the throne. I sure was glad I'd made it home.
Yeah,
when the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus. Saints of old with Him there. You could hear praying everywhere. When the clouds opened up and there stood Jesus.
Amen.
I love to sing the old songs.
Yeah, we don't hear them.
And I had a couple picked out and I wrote them down in front of the songbook. I turned on the internet last night and my wife hit a button and there's an old man on there singing a couple songs. And I marked them down and put it on the songbook and I said, I'll take my songbook tomorrow night now and I'll sing them two songs. But it didn't happen. But God is good to us.
Amen. All the time.
You know, a lot of people worry, I guess, about if they're going to make it home or not. I don't worry about that.
That's right.
Because I know.
Amen.
I've made peace with God.
Amen. That's right.
And the church, the church, Jesus died for the church. And set it up. It's a perfect church.
Amen.
That's right.
Not no spot, no blemish. I don't have to worry about man taking it out of my heart.
That's right. Amen. Thank God.
God put it in there.
That's right.
And God blessed me and lifted me up.
That's right.
You know, a lot of people, they try to go so high in this life that they actually miss the meaning of what being a Christian is.
Amen.
You know, the Lord come in when he saved my soul. I never did forget it, and it stuck with me. When God come into my soul and he changed me, I've heard people make the remarks that they didn't change for 6 months down the road, and maybe a year down the road, or 2 years, and I said, you wasn't saved.
Right.
When God come into my life and he touched me the day that I accepted the Lord,
yes, sir.
God changed me at that very moment.
Amen. Exactly.
When I came up out of the water,
yep.
And I'm not saying I was saved by baptism, but I was saved because I believed and I was baptized. I buried the old man of sin, and I rose a new man in Christ Jesus, and I never departed from there.
Yeah.
And God, when we got out, my wife asked me, she said, when we was changing clothes, she said, are we going to heaven now? And I said, no, we're going to work now. I didn't even know what I was saying to her. Didn't know what God had in mind for me.
Yeah.
But
preach it, brother.
Boy, I'm glad I followed him.
Amen.
I'm so glad people talk about being revived. Brother, I get revived when I sing an old song.
Yeah.
And the Spirit of God begins to move upon me. Listen, I can get revived.
Yes,
I was telling Donnie yesterday, when I come by to pick me up, I was running a little bit late, and I told him, I said, Donnie, I was in the bathroom getting ready to come to church when the Lord moved upon me. And I began to preach to myself.
Yes.
Brother, it was a good message.
Amen.
Nobody but me and God.
Amen.
But listen, you know, that's how God will revive you and
lift
you
up.
Brother, if you'll just hold on to God and draw just a little bit closer to him, and he'll get close to you. And the Bible says, listen here, that if we'll draw nigh unto him, that he'll draw nigh unto us. If you want to be revived, listen here. You don't have to gather here. You've got God.
Yeah.
The church is still in heaven. God is ahead of it. Listen, and he hears us all and what we call upon him. And when I begin, listen, to feel down and out, I begin to call upon the name of the Lord and say, Lord, here I am, and I need help, and I need you to lift me up. Brother, listen here. He's never failed me. He has never left me, brother. It's time that I call upon him.
Amen.
This God that we serve is not a dead God tonight.
Amen.
A lot of people, I think, have buried him. But brother, listen here. You should have buried the old man that was in your life. The Bible says that we must lose that old life, that we might pick up that new one in Christ.
Brother,
listen here. I never look back when I buried the old man of sin. Listen here, when I came out of the water, when I fulfilled what God told me to do, he said to repent. Listen here and be baptized. Brother, listen here. And when I rose up, I was a new man in Christ.
Amen.
Jesus. Listen here. Amen. God will change you and do away with your sins. Brother, we might need to be lifted up sometimes. But listen here. A call on the Creator. A brother that created you and made you what you are. A call upon God. If you want to be revived, listen here, he'll not turn you down. Brother, listen, his children, God knows where every one of them are at tonight. Listen here, none of them will perish.
if they'll call upon his name. The Bible said that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish. Listen here. The Bible says that God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Praise God tonight. If we believe in this Jesus who died upon the cross. Listen here. He said you have life and you have it more abundantly. Listen here. When he died upon the cross, he knew what he was dying for. Listen here. He said, lay not this sin upon them, for they know not what they do. Listen, old Stephen, when he was being stoned to death, listen here, he said, lay not this upon them, for they know not what they do. Praise God. I thank God tonight. Yeah, I know what I'm doing, because he changed me. Listen here, and he dressed me up, and he dressed me in the whole armor of God. Listen here, why should I fear the devil? God, he didn't send me out alone, but he dressed me up. Listen, he put the helmet of salvation upon me. Listen here, brother, he put the breastplate of righteousness on me. Listen, and he girded me with the truth.
Amen.
And sent me out with a two-edged sword, that I might go and preach the gospel unto them that are lost. The Bible said, unto them that believe, it is the power of God. But to them that believe not, it is foolishness. Brother, it's up to us to go preach unto them that they might listen and that they might hear and believe. Listen, the word that we preach to them. Listen here. Some preachers may think that it's too late, that we can't do anything with this generation that seems to be lost. Listen, and we can't turn them around. Listen here. Don't give up on God. Brother, God is still on the throne. Brother, listen here. And Jesus is sitting on the right hand of the Father, making intercession for the sins of them that want to come to the church. Brother, listen here. The old church, like the old song of the old ship of Zion, it's went through troubles before. It's been battered, but she never lost.
Right.
It's still sailing. Listen, and it's on the way to the other side. Listen here. If you'll get on board, God said he would give you eternal life.
Yeah.
Thank God for that. That God is not going. Listen here. The Bible said it's not God's will that any should perish, but that all would come to repentance. Thank God that he looked down. No doubt my mother prayed a many a prayer for me that I was lost, and she probably thought that I would never come. Listen here. But one day God come. God spoke to me. It wasn't my mother. It wasn't the preacher or my father, but it was God that came to me. And listen here. And then for the first time, I realized that I was lost. Listen, and headed for a devil's hell.
Yes, sir.
I was lost, but I couldn't convince myself. I didn't listen to nobody.
Amen. Bless him, Lord.
But God came. People talk about there's no God.
Boy.
I know who God is.
Yes,
I know Him. I've talked to Him. And He's come to my bed at night when I laid in the bed, not knowing what to do. God would come and visit and tell me everything's going to be all right. But today, brothers, we may be worrying when we look out and we see the pews empty and not too many people showing up. But it's going to be all right because God is still in charge. God sees every soul today that is lost. God hasn't took His eyes off His children. The children have took their eyes off of God, but He still knows where they are. Every one of them. Listen here, God is still calling.
Yes,
God is still calling people. It's just sometimes I hear the preacher say, you know, he said back in the 50s and the 60s is when the church was doing the greatest. He said people are just coming in groves and getting saved. He said we're just gleaning now. We're just cleaning up what's left over. Christ is about ready to come back to the church. And He said, we don't have the big crowds no more. And He said, not too many people are getting saved. He said, maybe we're just in the gleaning business. Sometimes it makes you wonder. But I can tell you this much, that the end of this whole world is coming.
Yes, sir.
They're trying to convince the people in the church that this is all a farce, that there's nothing to it. But listen here. I know better than this, because the Spirit of God talks to us. If we get close enough to Him, God will speak to us and tell us what's going on. When I look out and I say, how can people believe that there is no God? I can look around and look out in my yard and see things happening and I say, there is a God. There is a God. Because when I see the birds of the squirrels and all the animals and stuff around and I watch them, I say, there is a God.
That's right.
There is a God. Watch them work sometimes and see what God has done. Listen here, if He takes care of the animals out here and the birds, He's going to take care of us. We don't have to worry about this. God, why waste your time worrying about what you
can
do? God is going to do it in you.
That's right.
God is going to speak. So many people are worried today about the end of time coming. And listen, when it begins to get a little shaky and it looks bad like it was in 2000 when they thought the end of the world was coming and everything was going to shut down and everybody began to get scared. And my brother was telling me, he said they began to fill up the church house and began to ask him, are there anything to it? Do you think God is coming back? Listen, he said they all got scared. But as soon as it all died down, he said they left.
Yes,
you see, they figure there's a God coming. They figure there's an end coming. But they're going to carry on in their sin because the Bible said, listen here, that they love darkness rather than light. Listen here, and they would not come to that light because their deeds were evil and they didn't want their deeds exposed. So they kept in the dark. But the Bible says, he that doeth truth cometh to the light. Brother, that his deeds may be made manifest and wrought in God. That means works in God. We wanted them to know when we got saved. I wanted people to know what my works was. Brother, it was no longer of the devil.
It
was no longer in sin, but I was serving God, and I was going to stay on that road. Brother, listen here. If we dedicate ourselves to God, brother, listen, and love Jesus Christ, He said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Brother, you have to have love. I've seen people get in the church, get baptized, go a couple of Sundays and right back out in the world. Listen here, you didn't love Jesus. Brother, if you would have loved Him, you would have kept His commandments. You would have walked as he wants you to walk. Brother, listen here, and you would have been worthy of the vocation you're called in. Brother, and he would have blessed you. Listen here, the Bible said that when we are baptized, when we believe and are baptized, the Bible said that God will fill you with the Holy Ghost. Now, a lot of people today is even ashamed to use the word Holy Ghost. Brother, they're ashamed of it, and they won't talk about it. But listen, it's the Holy Ghost, the Bible says, and God puts in you, and it gives you the power to live and serve Him. Brother, without the Spirit of God, none of us tonight would be pleasing God. But because He filled us with His Spirit, listen, and sent us out. Brother, listen, a lot of people says He just sent the preachers out. No, He didn't just send the preachers out. He made the preacher the servant. Brother, but all of us are disciples of God, and we're to go out, listen, and spread the good news to the people, to our neighbors, and tell them what the Lord has done for you. Brother, that's what's wrong today. Nobody wants to tell their neighbor what the Lord has done for them. What has the Lord done for you? Brother, have you? Can you get up, listen, and testify about the Lord? Can you tell people what God has done for you? Has He made a change in you? If He hasn't, if He hasn't made a change in you, then you are lost and still wandering around in your sins. But the Bible says, listen, that the children of God, listen, we walk and we believe by faith.
That's right.
We walk by faith.
Yes, we do.
And we believe. Mm-hmm. Listen here. We can't please God without faith.
Amen. That's right.
We can't please Him.
That's right.
And we know this flesh don't please God.
No, sir.
So the only thing that God cleaned up was the inward man. Old Paul spoke about him, the inward man and the outward man. When the inward man wants to do something, the outward man is always fighting against him.
Yes, he is.
And when the outward man wants to do something, the inward man is fighting against him. A daily warfare, Paul said. Brother, have you ever fought the battle? Have you ever had it to go on in you? Many a times I fought the battle. The flesh against the spirit. And people will go out and they'll commit adultery, fornication, and do all these ungodly acts. And they'll say, the old flesh made me do it. The flesh made me do it. But what does the Bible say? The Bible says that that inward man that God cleaned up and washed and made white has power over the outward man.
Amen.
He's got power over him. He didn't give you that Holy Ghost just to be giving you something. He gave it to you to have power. People that go out and sin, they go out because they lust after it. They want to go sin. But listen here, that inward man that's of God, he's not going to allow that.
Amen.
If you've been saved, God has filled you with the Spirit, and it is stronger than the outward man.
Amen.
The outward man has no power. He has no power because God touched the inward man here, filled it with His Spirit, and made him stronger than the outward man. We have strength to fight against the devil. People say, the devil made me do it. No, you went and done it because you wanted to do it. You was drawn away of your own lust, and you went out and sinned. There's people in the church today that's sitting in the church pews. They go out and sin and have their little times and everything, and they say, I'm all right. Oh, Jesus called you a hypocrite. Jesus called you a hypocrite, and a man told me one time, he said, I'm not going down to your church, he said, because of the hypocrites. I said, listen, brother, the hypocrites ain't going nowhere. Only those that are saved. We try to separate it. Listen, we can't separate it. They're out there like the tares and the wheat.
Exactly.
Oh, God told us not to separate them. Let them grow together. He'll do the separating.
That's
we know that they're around. We know they're in the church.
Yeah.
But listen, the church can't get down because of that.
Amen.
The church has got to remain steadfast, unmovable.
Yeah.
Brother, listen here. Full of the Spirit of God. Go on singing the old hymns. Go on preaching the Word of God. There's going to be some that's going to laugh at you. There's going to be some, listen, that's going to mock you and scorn you. Jesus, they done everything in the world to Him. He said they're going to do it likewise to you.
Yes,
we can't be afraid.
First,
why should we be afraid? We know what's out there. We know what the devil's got. We once carried his tools for him.
Yeah, we did.
We know what he's got.
Uh-huh.
No use to be afraid.
That's right, brother.
What's the devil going to do to us? He's got my son, and he's turned him upside down.
Mm-hmm.
And I keep telling him, he's only got as much power as you let him have.
Exactly.
If you'll go down to church and you'll come up and repent of your sins and be baptized and let God remove that demon from you, you won't have no problem.
Amen, brother.
You won't have a problem. People trust more, and I'm talking about Christian people.
Oh, yeah.
Christian people trust more in a doctor. They'll
tell
go
it.
To the doctor and put all their faith in a doctor instead
tell it,
of
brother.
Putting it in God.
Yes, sir.
They'll do it. They've got more faith in the doctors than they have in God.
Absolutely.
Amen. If God, I look at it like this right here. I want people to pray for me when I get down sick.
Right.
But don't you pray for me that I live. You pray for me that I have an easy death.
Yes.
That God is there with me, and pray for my soul. Because when God gets ready to take me, He's going to take me, no matter what.
Yes.
And when He's done with me, I'm done.
No.
Don't keep me around.
Hey.
Let me go on to heaven.
Yeah.
That's
Amen.
What I believed in my whole life. I
yeah.
believe that there's a heaven.
Oh, absolutely.
And I believe that God is still there.
Yes.
So many people say, I believe in God, but nobody wants to die and go to heaven.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to die.
Yes,
why? There's a fear there.
Yes, they are.
They don't know what's over there on the other side. I know what's over there.
Yes, amen. Amen.
I know what waits me on the
brother.
Other side.
Amen.
I can't wait to get there. A lot of people, they say, you're talking crazy.
Yeah.
No, I'm not talking crazy.
Just tell
God said He went and prepared a place.
That's right.
Yes,
amen.
He did.
For the serving.
Amen.
Now He's got me a place over there.
Hallelujah.
He got it already.
Amen.
And when I get ready to leave here, the Bible says the old body's going to die.
Uh-huh.
Ain't a thing I can do about that. The body's going to die. But this soul is going to go to sleep in Christ.
Yeah, buddy.
And the Bible says that when God returns, He said with a shout and the voice of the archangel and the trumpet sounds, He's going to bring with Him,
Amen.
With Him, those that went to sleep in Christ. That means they're with Him. Nobody's suffering that served Him. They're with Him in heaven.
He's right.
They're with